Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Once again, very good morning to all. Probably in the last class, I hope we have discussed about these things, self-splitting, self-sectorization, and then interference part that we have seen, especially this adjacent channel interference and then co-channel interference. Okay, and I hope we have solved some problems also. And in today's class, we'll try to start up the concept of this trunking. And then grade of service, which is alternatively known as probability of blocking. And then we'll try to look at different radio systems, like trunk radio systems. There are two types of it. We'll try to see that, and then we'll try to solve some problems on it. Okay. And probably in the next class, we'll try to start the discussion on this handoff and then types of handoff. Okay. Quickly going, probably this we have seen it in the last class, adjacent channel interference. This because of the inadequate filtering. Because of these practical filters, a portion of that gets spilled over onto the adjacent channel. Hence, we call it as this portion as adjacent, okay, channel interference. This we have seen it in the last class. And then co-channel interference. This we said, okay, co-channel cell is basically where we are trying to use same set of frequencies. So if suppose this is the user, we said that okay, this is the wanted signal power. And then this is unwanted signal power, which is what we call it as interference. So signal power is inversely proportional to okay r power n. This is what we have seen in the mathematical derivation also. Similarly, interference power is inversely proportional to the distance between these two, that is d power n. Hence, we have got a mathematical description s by I equal to d by r whole power n. And okay, this is what we have seen it in the last class. And then clubbing these interferences, okay, the six interferences, we have said it in the last class, S by I, which is equal to what? These interference, if all of them are at equal distance, then we'll try to get this mathematical formula, assuming that, okay, there are six co-channel interference in the first tier, so you'll get m d power minus n. All these things we have seen it in the last class, and this is the essential formula with which we have solved some problems. Signal interference ratio is equal to d by r whole power n by m, or d by r is equal to frequency reduce factor, which is equal to square root of 3n, where okay, and whole power n, this n is nothing but your path loss component. Okay, so these things I hope you have seen it in the last class. Keeping these things in the mind, okay. Apart from that, this worst case scenario, we're assuming that okay, two of them are at d minus r and two of them are at d plus r, and then remaining are at d. So when we derive this particular formula, okay. So keeping those things in the mind, and then apart from that, I hope you have solved some problems also. So let's look into the other concept of trunking and then grade of service. Basically, in this, what we are trying to do it is trunking is basically you have generally in olden days also. Or probably in the initial first generations or before first generation mobiles, okay, we used to have this landline communications where in telephone exchange we used to have different switches. Suppose if a person A wants to communicate with B, then A would be requesting, okay, the exchange, and then in the exchange there will be a physical path through this particular switch. So that means in exchange you can see that you have a limited number of switches available. So obviously, you have to utilize this limited number of switches, okay, with large number of users. Okay, this particular thing, this particular concept of utilizing a limited number of resources with unlimited or probably the large number of users is what we call it as a concept of trunking. Okay, so that is in case of wired communication, we would like to have a wire between your transmitter and receiver. So hence, you should make okay you have to make this the a channel that is available. That channel is nothing but a wire. that we have seen it in that okay would be the case in case of wired communication. So same is the case in case of wireless communication. In case of wireless communication, generally the signal is being propagated in free space. So what do we understand by a channel in this case? Okay, channel in the sense it could be a frequency slot or a time slot or a code. Okay, so this I hope we have seen in the case of GSM. We have a limited number of channels, a spectrum of 125 megahertz, 125 channels. So that 125 channels is each one is a channel. So you have a limited number of channels that are available, but you have large number of users. So how effectively we are going to use these limited number of resources with this unlimited number of users or a large set of users is what basically the concept of trunking. It is basically developed by Erlang, a scientist named Erlang. So hence on his name, the traffic intensity on a particular channel is being measured in terms of Erlangs. So just coming to the basic definition of trunking, as I said, trunking is basically allowing large number of users to utilize a small number of resources depending upon requests. Means a user will be requesting for a particular channel, and if the channel is available, that channel would be allocated to the user. That means on request basis, we are utilizing that particular channel, and once the channel is free, then it will be given back to the system. Hence, this trunk system would be allocating this. This can be allocated to some other user. So, basic definition I am writing it is, it allows a large number of users to share the relatively small number of channels, okay, in a cell by providing access to each user on demand from a pool of available channels. So the concept of trunking basically allows us to utilize this large number, utilize this small number of resources for large number of users depending upon request basis. The moment when the person requests, if the channel is available, that channel would be allocated to the user. If the channel is not available, then that gets blocked. The user gets blocked or call will be lost for us. So this is the basic concept of trunking. Okay, on this particular thing, like kind of systems that we have and all those things, we'll try to develop. So basically, trunking is allowing a large number of users to share the small number of channels. And be careful, the moment when I'm calling it as a channel, okay, this channel can be anything. This channel can be a frequency slot, in the case of GSM that we have considered, where we had 25 megahertz spectrum that is available, and each is having a bandwidth of 200 kilohertz. So total of 125 channels that are available. So if a user is requesting for a channel, then a channel will be allocated to him, like F1 is being allocated to that particular user. And once the particular user, after using that, he will return back that particular channel to the system, so that this can be allocated to somebody else. So here you can see that in a particular area, you have only 125 number of channel that is available, and out of that 125 number of channel that are available, you are supposed to utilize these limited number of channels have to be utilized by large number of users. Probably in a particular cell, you may expect thousands of users. Okay, so what you have to do is, on request basis, we would be allocating that particular channels. So the channel can be a frequency slot if we are trying to go for a frequency division multiple access. In a way, it is very much similar to that of your multiple access technique. Multiple access means what? Multiple persons are trying to access the common resources. So in case of FDMA, you have a frequency slot that is available. Channel means it can be a frequency slot, or time division means you can have a time slot. Means what? Same channel can be given to one user on one particular time, and then probably other time it would be allocated to somebody else. Or if I want to utilize both frequency as well as time, then I'll try to go for code division multiple access. That means each person will be having different code. So channel in the sense, it can be anything. Either it may be a frequency, or it may be a time, or time slot, or it may be a code, or maybe combinations of these things. So ultimately you have a limited number of resources or limited number of channels that are available with us, and we have to utilize these limited number of channels with a large number of users. So that means this large number of users have to share this limited number of channels. So this is the concept of basically trunking, and how do we do it and all those things. Okay, with the basic terminology, let us look into it. As we said, okay, this Erlang is basically the scientist name, and the measure of traffic intensity, units for measure of traffic intensity, is being given on his name. So basically one Erlang means it is unit of a traffic intensity, so amount of traffic that is carried by a channel is being measured by in terms of Erlangs. Okay, so one Erlang means basically, generally one Erlang means, you can see that the amount of, I'm just looking at one Erlang, one unit of Erlang means amount of traffic intensity carried by a channel that is completely occupied. Suppose that means you have a channel, suppose a channel is being allocated for you, and what you are trying to do is, suppose it is allocated for you for 1 hour and you are using it for only 30 minutes. That means how much time you are occupying? Only 30 minutes, 30 out of 60. So 30 by 60 is nothing but the, that means the traffic intensity that you have, it is 30 by 60, that is equal to what? Half Erlang. That is the unit of traffic intensity. Or one Erlang means what? What you are trying to say, it is amount of traffic intensity carried by a channel that is completely occupied. Means what? If a channel is being given for you for 1 hour and you are putting your information completely for 1 hour, that means 60 by 60, 60 minutes by 60 minutes, that is equal to one. That is what we call it as one Erlang. It can be, it is, so that is one call hour per hour or one call minute per minute. Okay, in other words, simply if a channel is being allocated for you for 1 minute, and suppose if you are using it for only 30 seconds or probably 40 seconds, what is the traffic intensity? 40 by 60. 4 by 6 is the 4 by 6 Erlangs of the traffic that you are putting on that particular channel. Or suppose if it is allocated for you for 1 minute and you are using it completely for 1 minute, that means 1 minute by 1 minute is nothing but the 1 Erlang. So the traffic intensity that you are putting on a particular channel is what? 1 Erlang. Okay, so just a concept of trunking and the unit for traffic intensity is being covered in this particular slide. Okay, now we'll try to see the basic terminology that we are going to use it. Okay, these are the terms that one has to understand quite clearly. Okay, first, setup time. Setup time is, and most of these terms go by the name. Okay, simply, setup time is, suppose if you are a user and you are trying to request a channel. Okay, the moment when you wanted to make a call, so you would request the system to allocate a channel. So time taken by the trunked radio system or a particular system, time taken by the system to allocate a channel for you so that you can communicate, okay, is what, that particular time we call it as a setup time. So setup time is basically time taken by the system to allocate a channel for you is what we call it as setup time. Okay, so time required to allocate a trunked radio channel to a requesting user. So for a requesting user, how much amount of time is required by the system to allocate a channel is what we call it as setup time. Means what? When I'm trying to make a call, first I'll try to request the system. So now what the system does is, system looks at the channels whether they are available or not, and if they are available, then it will be allocated to you. So how much amount of time is being taken by the system to allocate a channel to you is what we call it as setup time. So obviously it is a time, so you will measure in terms of seconds. Okay, and the second term, blocked call. Okay, now you are trying to talk with somebody. So what do you do? Generally, you will try to request a channel to the system. Now, when you are trying to request a system to allocate a particular channel, now if the channels are available with the system, then a channel will be allocated for you. You will try to talk. But if the channels are not available with the system, then it cannot allocate a channel to you. In that case, you will be blocked. So hence, you will not be allocated any particular channel. Okay, such particular concept is, we call it as blocked call. Your call gets blocked because of the non-availability of the channel at the system. Because in trunking, you have only limited number of channels that are available and large number of users. If all of them wants to talk simultaneously, definitely, okay, you will not be able to, okay, get a particular channel. Hence, your call gets blocked. Hence, that particular term, we call it as blocked call. So, blocked call is basically at the time of requesting, okay, to the system, if the channel is not available, your call gets blocked. Or in other words, you will call it as a lost call. So, it is basically a call which cannot be completed at time of request due to congestion. Congestion in the sense, all the channels are congested or all the channels are being allocated to somebody else. Okay, hence there are no channels that are available. Okay, that is the term blocked call. In other words, we also refer to as lost call. Blocked calls is basically being measured in terms of probability of blocking. Okay, like suppose there are suppose probability of blocking a call is equal to 0.1. Means what? 1 out of 10. Means out of 10 calls, 1 will be blocked. That is how you try to measure it. That we'll try to see it. Now, the other term is holding time. Holding time is, now suppose, okay, a channel is being allocated for you and you are utilizing that particular channel. And as the name itself indicates, holding time means on an average, how much amount of time you try to hold that particular channel. Okay, on an average, how much amount of time you would hold that particular channel is what we call it as holding time. Okay, so average duration of a typical call means what? How much amount of time you are trying, how much amount of time you are on a call. So that, okay, so much amount of time you are trying to hold that particular channel. So holding time is basically average duration of a typical call. And it is denoted by capital H. Obviously it is time. So hence you have the units as seconds. And the other one is request rate. Request rate is something, okay, it is with respect to an individual user. Request rate is basically number of requests that you are getting per unit time. So if I am a user, okay, how many number of calls per unit time I am getting it. Okay, it is different for different individuals. Okay, so request rate is number of requests or number of calls that you are getting per unit time is what, okay, we call it as request rate. Okay, the average number of call requests per unit time. And this can be, that means number of calls you're getting per minute or number of calls per second or number of calls per hour. Okay, this unit time, you can define it in any way. But all those things should be defined in the same unit. Either it may be in hours or maybe minutes or in seconds. Accordingly, you have to make that particular changes while doing calculations. Okay, so but request rate is basically what? Basically the average number of call requests per unit time. Okay, that means per unit time, how many number of calls that you are getting it. And the units for it is per second, because you know that it is per unit time. So it is 1 by second is the unit per it. It is denoted by lambda. Okay, it is denoted by lambda. Remember these two things: holding time is H and request rate is lambda. Okay, so with individual user, when I'm trying to talk, request rate is what? Lambda. That means he is getting lambda calls per unit time and each call is holding for a time of H. That gives me the traffic intensity that you have per each user. So at a later stage, we'll try to see lambda multiplied by H is what? the traffic intensity for each user. We'll try to define that later, but you can see that these two are quite important in defining the traffic intensity of each user. Because if you are a user, first, if I wanted to find out what is the traffic intensity that is being offered by you, then what do I do basically? First, I'll try to see on an average per unit time how many number of calls that you're going to get, and each call how long you're holding it. So that so much amount of time you're utilizing that particular channel, or so much amount of time you are putting the information on that particular channel. Hence, so much amount of traffic that you are putting on that particular channel. That is nothing but traffic intensity. Okay, so these are quite simple, and going by the name, one can understand. Setup time is time required for the system to allocate a channel to you. And block call is, if the channel is not available, your call gets blocked. Holding time is, on an average, how much amount of time you are going to talk, or on an average, how much amount of time you are holding a particular channel. And request rate is number of call requests that you are getting per unit time. Okay, quite simple terminology, but I need to utilize it properly. Okay, further continue. So as I said, traffic intensity. Okay, traffic intensity is basically, as I said, measure of channel time utilization. So a channel is being allocated to you, and how much time you are utilizing that particular channel. Okay, a channel is being allocated to you, and how much time you are trying to utilize that particular channel. That is what we call it as measure of channel time utilization, is what we call it as traffic intensity or average occupancy. On an average, how much channel is being occupied, okay, is what traffic intensity. So measure of channel time utilization means what? Once the channel is being allocated to you, how much time you are utilizing this particular channel. Okay, measure of channel time utilization, which is basically average channel occupancy. How much amount of time that you are trying to occupy that particular channel is what we call it as traffic intensity. And as we said, the units for this traffic intensity are erlangs, measured in erlangs, and this is denoted by A, denoted by A, capital A. Okay, this is traffic intensity for each channel, means what? For each user you can consider. Now load, the other term is load. Load is basically traffic intensity. We are talking about this traffic intensity to each user. So let us assume that each user is having a traffic intensity A, or A suffix U, indicating A for each user. Load is, what is the total traffic that you have in a particular system? Means what? The total number of users, okay? How much amount of traffic intensity by each user? That is what the total traffic intensity, and that is what you call it as load. Load is basically traffic intensity across the entire system. Traffic intensity across entire system. This is traffic intensity of a particular user. Okay, and then if you have total system, and what is the traffic intensity of the total system, we call it as load of that particular system. Okay, so again, this is also being measured in erlangs. Basically, this is denoted by A, capital A, and this is denoted by A suffix U. But this is general definition, hence I did not keep that. And then comes the term grade of service. We have started with saying that ranking and grade of service. Ranking and grade of service. Grade of service is basically, in other words, grade of service is basically, we call it as how much service that you are giving it. Or suppose it is basically probability of blocking a particular call. Probability of blocking a particular call. The other name for this grade of service is probability of blocking a particular call. Or in other words, now what do you mean by probability of blocking a particular call? When I'm trying to request a particular channel, if the channels are not available, your call gets blocked. So now, what is probability of blocking? Means what? Suppose probability of blocking equal to, as I said, 0.01. Means what? 1 by 100. Means out of 100 requests, one user gets blocked. Out of 100 requests, one user is getting blocked. Probability of blocking. Suppose probability of blocking equal to 0.01, I am taking. 0.01 means what? 1 by 100. That means what? One out of 100 calls gets blocked. Means what? For one out of 100 users, you are not able to provide the service. You are not able to provide the service. So grade of service, in other words, we say probability of blocking. Or grade of service is basically measure of congestion. We'll just name it as measure of congestion. Congestion means what? How you have a channels and how congested your channels are. Means what? Because all the channels are being allocated to somebody else. That means all of them are being occupied. They're already congested. If a new user is coming into picture, as the channels are congested, so he's not able to, a call is not being given to him, or a channel is not being given to him. Hence, he gets blocked. Hence, we call it as a probability of blocking a particular call. So try to understand these terms clearly. Grade of service is measure of congestion, or simply it is being represented as probability of call being blocked. Okay? So you can write grade of service is a measure of congestion. Measure of congestion, which is specified as probability of call being blocked. So basically, grade of service is probability of call being blocked. And this we'll try to see along B and along C. Okay, a measure of congestion, which is specified as the probability of call being blocked. Okay, or the probability of a call being delayed beyond a certain amount of time. Okay, so basically there are two types of system. One is erlang B and erlang C. This we will try to look at it probably, okay, a little later. Like here we are saying that, okay, this is basically what, when a user is requesting a particular call or a particular channel, if the channels are available, you will allocate it. If the channels are not available, straight away you will try to block that particular call. Okay, hence we call that as a probability of blocking. That is in the first case. In the second case, what do you do is, if the channels are not available, you request the user to wait for some time. That means you push the user into a queue, and he has to wait in the queue for a certain amount of time. During then, if the channels are becoming free, during that particular time, if the channels are becoming free, then that channel would be allocated to the user. Even after waiting so much time in the particular queue, still if the channels are not becoming free, your call gets blocked. Okay, so the second system is providing some queue. Probability of call being delayed beyond a certain amount of time. That means you will specify some delay and you will wait so much time, giving a busy tone. And then after that, beyond that also, if the channels are not becoming free, you will be blocked. Means what? Again, probability of blocking. Hence, grade of service. So, if there is delay provided, then we call such a system as erlang C. And if there is no delay, then it is erlang B. We'll try to see these two things, okay, a little, okay, probably after one or two slides, clearly. But again, we are trying to understand grade of service here. Grade of service is basically a measure of congestion. Means how congested your channels are. So, you have the channels along with you, and these channels, if all the channels are being occupied, that means already others are trying to put their information, that means already they are congested. So no new, okay, user is being given a particular channel. Hence that particular user gets blocked. Means what? You are not providing service to that particular user. Hence you are trying to block that call, probability of blocking, or we name that as grade of service. So be careful, grade of service, the other name, we can take it as probability of blocking. Grade of service, or we can name it as probability of blocking. Okay. Now, that is the basic terminology that we had so far. Now we'll try to see the relation between these terms. As we said, traffic intensity offered by each user. Just now we have seen it. Traffic intensity by each user. We said traffic in each user traffic intensity is A suffix U. Okay, and that is equal to what? For each user, you'll try to see how many requests that you are getting per unit time, and on an average how much amount of time that you are holding that. So lambda multiplied by H. So A suffix U is nothing but what? Traffic intensity of each user, which is equal to what? Request rate multiplied by holding time. So that is equal to what? Lambda into H. This is the mathematical formula. Traffic intensity for each user. See, while doing mathematical calculations, you require these things. So try to be careful with these terms. So A suffix U is equal to what? Lambda into H. Now, for a system with U number of users, the total offered traffic, or this is nothing but load. Total offered traffic is nothing but what? Load. We are assuming that the traffic intensity of each user is A suffix U. And suppose you have U number of users in that. Or suppose if I am saying that, okay, traffic intensity of each user is 0.1 erlang, and there are 10 users. So what is the total traffic? 10 multiplied by 0.1 erlang. 10 users, each one is providing, is offering a traffic of 0.1. So 10 multiplied by 0.1 is nothing but what? 1 erlang. So the total load, it would be 1 erlang. So A, the total load is equal to what? U into AU, where U is the number of users that we have, and A suffix U is traffic of each user, traffic intensity offered by each user. Okay, these are quite important in doing calculations, because later we'll try to solve some problems. Be careful with this. And then, okay, let's see. As we said, okay, now the total traffic that you have is A. Total traffic in the system is A. Okay, now let us assume that you have only C channels available with you. Total traffic is A, and you have only trunk system with C channels. That means you have the number of channels that are available with you is C. So what is the traffic intensity that you have to keep on each channel? Traffic intensity per channel means what? Total traffic divided by the number of channels. Total traffic. Okay, total traffic A is equal to what? U into AU divided by C gives me traffic intensity for each channel. Traffic intensity that it has to carry, like each channel has to carry. Okay, like you can see that these are the terms. Okay, like any one will be asked, and the other thing that you have to find it out. So quickly, traffic intensity of each user is what? Basically lambda times H, where lambda is a request rate multiplied by the holding time. And if there are U number of users, total traffic of the system is equal to what? Number of users multiplied by the traffic intensity of each user. And if there are C channels that are available, okay, so each channel, how much it has to carry. This is total traffic, and this total traffic has to be carried by total number of channels. So how much amount of traffic that you are putting on each channel is what? Simply A by C. Okay, so this is the simple terms, and then some mathematical relations among them. These are useful in doing calculations that we will try to see. And there are two types of these trunk systems, as I said, okay, previously. One is blocked calls. One is blocked calls cleared system, and the other one would be blocked calls delayed system. Okay, two types of these trunk systems. One is blocked calls cleared system. Another one is blocked calls delayed system. Second one we'll try to see it later. As I said, blocked calls cleared system, which is what we named it as just now. Okay, we have seen erlang B. Okay, what we'll try to do in this is, suppose if a user is requesting for a channel, if the channels are available, okay, an immediate access will be given to the user. So channel will be allocated, and he'll be completing that particular call. If the channels are not available, if the channels are not available, then your call gets blocked. Means what? Blocked calls, you're trying to clear. Because if the channels are not available, you're trying to block that particular call and you're trying to clearing that. That means you're not storing anywhere. So simply, if it is blocked, and again, when he's trying to access for a channel, again, he'll become a fresh user. He'll not be given any priority kind of thing. So blocked calls cleared system means what? Whatever the blocked calls that you are having, you are trying to clear them then and there itself. Okay, such a kind of system we call it as blocked calls cleared system. So user who requests service given immediate access to channel, provided the channels are available. If a user is requesting for a service, if the channels are available, immediate access will be given. If no channels available, user is blocked. Once it is blocked, you will not keep that information. Hence you are trying to clear that. Hence we call that as block calls cleared system. As we said, this is Erlang B formula. We'll try to use it. Erlang B formula, we'll try to use it. Just now we said in grid of service, Erlang B and Erlang C. So this is Erlang B formula, and Erlang B formula is this. Look at this, probability of blocking, which is equal to grid of service. So either you name it as grid of service, or you can call it as probability of blocking. So this is this mathematical, see the derivation for these things, are not required for us. Even in fact, for that matter, we are not going to utilize this formula also. We have other methods to get the values from it. We'll try to see it. So just let us try to understand this particular formula. Probability of blocking or grade of service depends upon, what are the terms? A is nothing but what? Total traffic. And C is number of channels. This is already number of channels, and that is the only thing that you have. K is a dummy variable here. So it is basically relation between three components. One is grade of service or probability blocking. Probability, or let me look at it from this. Probability of blocking, the load, total traffic intensity, and C is number of channels. So it is relation between these three. Probability of blocking, it is simply probability. Probability of blocking or GOS, that is one component. Traffic, total traffic, second component, and the number of channels. So depending upon number of channels and traffic, you'll get probability of blocking. Or for a particular probability of blocking, if you know the traffic and the number of channels that you have to make available, you can calculate it. Or in other words, probability of blocking is given and then available channels are given. So you'll be able to find out the amount of traffic that, that you can cover. So these are all these things you can interchange and you can find it out. But ultimately, this is a relation between three components. One is total traffic, number of channels, probability of blocking. This is blocked calls cleared system. Again, I'm repeating, this formula we are not going to utilize, but you have a graph for these things. You have graphs for these things, which gives us the relation between A, C, and this. So from the graph, any two will be given, you will pick the third one. So that is how we will try to do the mathematical calculation, that we will try to see it. So that is the reason why, I have given just this particular formula. And this is one system, that is blocked calls cleared system. So blocked calls cleared system means what? If your call, as the channels are not available, your call gets blocked and you're clearing that particular blocked calls. That's what blocked calls cleared system. Other thing that we said, it is blocked calls delayed system. Other one is blocked calls delayed system. So that means, as I said previously, you are trying to use some delay, or you are trying to use some queue here. You are trying to have some memory here. In this case, what you are trying to do is, again, user is requesting for a particular channel. If the channels are available, immediate access will be given. But if the channels are not given, your call does not block, does not get blocked. In this create system, we are trying to block that. But here, what you do is immediately you will not block. Rather than that, what you do is you ask that user to wait in a particular queue for a certain duration of time. During that particular time, if any of that particular time, if the channels are becoming free at the system side, what it will be done is immediately access will be given to you. Suppose even after waiting for so long in that particular queue, still the channels are not becoming free, then you are trying to block that particular call. Hence, you will get probability of blocking. The advantage with this is you are asking the user to wait for certain time. So obviously, immediately you are not blocking. So he's waiting there, and then by the time if the channels are becoming free, you are allocating it. Hence, the probability of blocking would be quite less here. Okay. Hence, and one more advantage that you have it is the user who is here. Okay, you are trying to store that particular user, and you are asking them to get into a queue so that you will know who is coming first, and accordingly you are trying to give that priority to that particular users. So these two are the advantages that you have when you have blocked calls, delayed system. So user who requests service given immediate access to channel provided the channels are available. If no channel available, user is queued for a specific time. If still the channel is not available, user gets blocked. Okay, so this is Erlang C. Okay, so mathematical formulas for this is a little bit complicated than this, because first I have to see here whether the channels are not available. If the channels are not available, then he has to get into that queue. That means probability that delay has to be greater than zero. First thing, probability of delay should be greater than zero. And then on top of that, you have to see probability that delay has to be greater than a specific amount of time. Okay. Hence, we will try to use this. Probability of delay greater than zero is a power c by a power c plus c factorial 1 minus a by c. Again, you can see that all these things are probability, traffic, and channels. Okay, and this is only probability that you will get into queue. Delay greater than zero means what? You are entering into queue. It is not probability of blocking. Okay, probability that delay greater than zero is basically what? You are trying to enter into queue. So you are immediately not blocking. Now, on top of this, what is that you have to find out? Probability that delay greater than a specific time. Means what? Probability that delay greater than t. Probability that delay greater than t. Once it is greater than zero, what is the probability that it is greater than t? Okay, a simple probability that you have greater than t given delay greater than zero multiplied by probability of delay greater than zero. Okay, this is the formula that you have. Probability of delay greater than t is nothing but what? Probability that delay greater than zero multiplied by probability that delay greater than t given delay greater than zero. Because first it has to happen. Delay has to be greater than zero means what? The channels are not available. That is indicating that channels are not available. Immediately you are not blocking. When will you block? Even after waiting certain amount of time in that queue, and that time is t. That means if it is delay is greater than t, that means you have waited in that queue more than t seconds. Hence now it will be blocked. Hence probability that delay greater than, that is equal to what? This is what first and foremost thing is, this has to happen, okay? And basically this given, this has to happen. Okay, conditional probability that you have. And for this term, mathematical formula is exponential distribution. Delay greater than t given delay greater than zero. Okay, you can see that this is same. This is also same. Only this mathematical formula is probability of delay greater than t given delay greater than zero is exponential of minus c minus a into t by h, where c is number of channels, a is the traffic, t is the amount of time that you are waiting, and h is the holding time. Okay, as I said again, these mathematical formulas we are not going to utilize. Rather than that, we will try to utilize the graphs, and that graphs we call it as, either you call it as Erlang B or we call this as Erlang C chart, Erlang B or Erlang C chart, and from that particular chart you will get the value. Okay, for example, let us try to look into it. Okay, let me look at this Erlang B chart. Erlang C would also be very much similar. I'll just try to look into this so that, okay, things become quite simple. So this is the chart that you have. Okay, let us try to understand this. As we said, you can see this is this mathematical formula. Okay, on how many terms it is depending? On one side, probability of blocking and the total traffic and the channels. Three parameters that you have. Okay, these are three parameters that you have. So probability of blocking, one, number of channels, two, traffic intensity, three. So you have these three terms, one, two, three. So at any point of time, okay, in the particular problem, any two will be given and you have to find the third one from this graph. For example, let us consider this. Let us assume that the probability of blocking is 0.0005. Okay, this is the probability of blocking. What does it mean? 5 by 1000 means what? Out of 1000 users, 5 persons gets blocked. Okay, so probability of blocking is this, and see that I am trying to take this curve. I am trying to attach to this. That means this is the number of channels, and the number of channels that are available is 5. Number of channels that are available is, you can see that these are number of channels. 1 means this line I have to consider, 2 means this line I have to consider, 3 this line, and then 4 and 5. Okay, so 5 is the number of channels that are available. So what I have to do is, with this probability of blocking and with this number of channels available, how much amount of traffic that you can cover means that I have to find out. For that, what I have to do is, I have to write a perpendicular line from here to here and I have to take that particular value. See, this is what. So you can see that. Now you can see, for probability of blocking of 0.005, for a channels of 5, what is the total traffic that I have? You can see that this is log kind of, you can see the units on this. This is 0.1 and this one is 1. Is it correct or not? Means what? This is 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.9, and then 1. Again, 1 to 10. Similar graph kind of thing. 1, this would be 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on, 9 and 10. Then 10 here, 10 to 100. Means what? 20, 30, 90, 100. So what could be this particular value? You can see that this is 1 and this is 2. So somewhere around 1.1 I am trying to consider. So for a probability of blocking or a grade of service of 0.005, for a channels of 5, probability, okay, traffic intensity is 1.1, somewhere around 1.13. Okay, this is for a channel numbers 5. Or suppose if you have same probability of blocking, but the number of channels are 10. Number of channels are 10. Then what is the traffic? You can see that this is 1, 2, 3, and you can see that this is 4. This is a line 4. So approximately 4. Okay, so 4 A equal to 4. So from this particular graph, you have to pick the value. Either A, GOS will be given, you need to find C, or C, GOS will be given, you need to find this, or this and this given, you need to find this. Okay, just for understanding, quickly, let us look into the problem very quickly. Just let us try to understand this problem. How many users can be supported for 0.5% blocking probability for the following number of trunked channels in a blocked calls cleared system? See, when I'm saying blocked calls cleared system, you have to use Erlang B chart. For whatever I have shown is Erlang B chart. And for blocked calls delayed system, you have to use Erlang C chart. So 5, 10, and assume each user generate 0.1 Erlangs of traffic. forget about this. Okay, just let's look at problem up to this point. How many users can be supported for 0.5% blocking probability for the following number of trunk channels in the block calls clear system? So that means he's saying that I have 5 channels, part A, if I'm trying to consider, 5 channels are available for a probability of blocking of 0.5%. How many users can be covered? How many users can be supported? How many users can be supported? And one more thing that he is giving it is, each user generates 0.1 erlangs of traffic. So looking at the terms, what all are the things given? This is GOS, rate of service or probability of blocking 0.5%. And this is number of channels C. And this is each user generates 0.1 erlangs, that is A suffix U. Okay. And how many users can be supported? What is being asked? Number of users, that is capital U. And where do you get that capital U? Total traffic A is equal to what? U times traffic of each user. Total traffic is equal to what? U times A suffix U. So you need to find it out. And you know AU is given. So you have to find out A, capital A, traffic. And how do you find that total traffic? You can see that probability of blocking is given and the number of channels are being given. Just now we have seen 0.5% grade of service, 5 channels. 0.5% grade of service is this, and 5 channels is this, C equal to 5. What is that particular value? Somewhere around 1.1. So A value you are getting here as 1.1, somewhere around 1.1. So from this graph, you are getting capital A, that is total traffic intensity. And you know that A equal to U into AU. So U equal to what simply? A by AU. Similarly, the second problem is in the same thing, for the same GOS, 10 number of channels. So this is 10 number of channels. What is that particular value? A equal to this, 3.96 or probably 4. Okay. So given C equal to 5 for A portion, number of channels is 5 and AU equal to 0.1 erlangs, GY is equal to 0.5%, means 0.005. So from erlang B chart, from that particular chart, what is the value of A that I'm considering? 1.13. Just now we have seen 0.05 to 5 channels, we have got it 1.13. So how many users it can be supported? You know that A equal to 1.13 and AU equal to 0.1. U equal to what? A by AU. 1.13 by 0.1, which is equal to what? 11 users. Similarly, you have to repeat it for B. C equal to 10. For C equal to 10, A equal to again 0.1, GY is equal to 1. For 10 and 0.05, from erlang B chart, we have got it approximately 4. That is 3.96. So total number of users would be what? 3.96 A by AU, which is equal to what? 39 users. Okay, that is how you calculate. That is how you do the problems. Okay, and you can see that I have kept it in some other color, like each user averages 2 calls per hour at an average call duration of 3 minutes. Okay, so that means this particular thing, each user generates 0.1 erlangs. Directly AU is given here. Directly AU is given. But instead of giving in this way, I can give even in this way. That means instead of giving AU directly, I'll give lambda and H. Each user averages 2 calls per hour. This is request rate, lambda. Lambda equal to 2 by 60. Right? 2 by 60. Okay? And then call duration of 3 minutes. H is 3. Okay? So if I'm calculating that, okay, 2 by 60 into 3. Okay? So you can see that again you will get 0.1 erlangs of traffic. So this you can, AU is directly given, or maybe in terms of this is given. So problem looks complicated, but the amount of calculation that you have to make it quite simple. Okay, we'll do one thing. Probably I have some other problem also. You can see this is completely, this is the problem. Problem looks quite bigger, but solution is quite simple. Let us do this in the next class. Okay.